Good evening and welcome to ATV News. I'm Shalama Lawson with today's bulletin. Coming up, Bulawayo residents react to the conviction of a man who used strong herbal medicines in an attempt to kill his wife's lovers. Dog owners are benefiting from a new vaccination program for their pets. A Harare man has been entertaining the city with his street performances. And a golf tournament aims to raise money for the underprivileged people. Residents in Bulawayo have expressed mixed feelings over the conviction of a man who used strong herbal medicines to lock his wife. Locking aims to inflict a slow, painful death on any man who sleeps with the woman in question, with similar effects to HIV. Crispin Tabura reports.
A 32-year-old Bulawayo man was last week convicted and jailed for 3 months for fencing his wife in a juju practice commonly known as Olunyoka. If a man bears the wife of a man with Olunyoka juju powers, he can die usually from swollen legs, stomach and private parts. There were mixed reactions over the conviction of Tawanda Mufari, who is said to have locked his wife.
Kune uyo atora mkazi wake akabvisa fuma kuvabereki ikagamuchirwa zvakanaka ava nemudzimai wake anti haachatenderi kuti mudzimai uyu arare neumwe munhu. Saka kana akagonakisa ruzhowa rwake akanaka, because mukadzi wake kana iye achimuda, kunze kana iye achishotesawo zvimwe zvinhu kumukadzi uyu, lese haasi kuuya kumba ndopangaita nyaya.
Because mukadzi ndiari wrong, iye aizoenda kubuda kunze kuenda kunohura sei aine murume. And anga singafani kutosungisa murume wake, that's because murume akamuudza before.
First case came to light after his wife reported him to the police over his Olunyoka powers, and some residents put blame on inyangas.
Ngibona engani inyanga lezi sezigcwele laba profit, injongo yabo ihuhuquluza inotho yabantu, ukuthathela abantu impahla zabo, njalo bethatha i-advantage yokuthi abantu bahluphekile. Kungabe kuyimkhuhlane abantu befuna ukusila, angiboni genuine ukwenza kwabo.
Zimbabwe National Traditional Healers Association registered inyanga Sikanyisiwe Mzila condemned the use of Olunyoka as cruel.
Traditional healers angiwakomenti ukuthi nika abantu imithi enjengayo naleyo, ngoba imithi encindisela abantu. Kuyafana lokhu ubulala umuntu lokhu, ngoba umuntu wangikhona phela loya uthi umnikile umuntu wangikhona engavuke efile umuntu lwana yena sesale senza njani.
There are very few inyangas who treat Olunyoka, and the risks are high for any man who might come into contact with Mfari's ex-wife. It's a problem with no easy answers. I'm Chris Bentabra, reporting for ATV in Bulawayo, Zimbabwe.
Dog owners in Bulawayo are benefiting from a dog vaccination program that will help control the outbreak of rabies in the city. Eunice Verizai gives us more.
The Veterinary Services Department has embarked on a program to vaccinate dogs in Bulawayo to prevent the outbreak of animal-related diseases. The district veterinary officer, Dr. Ndabesi Nhlemkwanazi, said that the vaccination program, which will be run this month, had a tremendous response.
The Department of Veterinary Services in Bulawayo, Government Veterinary Services, is carrying out a rabies vaccination program throughout the whole city, whereby we are compelling all dog owners to bring their dogs for vaccination.
ATV caught up with some residents whose dogs were being treated at Pardon Health Shopping Center.
I think it's a very good exercise that should be done regularly for the better of the dogs and the better health of the dogs and kids at large.
Rabies vaccination. It's good the government brings it to us instead of us going that way.
I came in to get my dog injected for the rabies thing and all that. It's actually a safety precaution because it saves people from getting a rabies infection. So I would actually recommend more people to come and get their dogs injected for the rabies virus.
siyabonga ukuthi sizohlabisa izinja ngenxa ukuthi nxa sihlabisile khona izinja zingasoze zikube lo mkhuhlane nxa yabiluma umuntu kuyanceda kakhulu ebantwini ngoba inja inyamazane iyahluphe ngaba lo mkhuhlane.
Dr. Mkwananzi also reiterated that people who own dogs should vaccinate their dogs regularly.
Regular deworming for your dogs is also recommended. Also control external parasites by either dipping or using powders which can kill all the parasites.
Dog owners are required by law to have their dogs vaccinated against rabies disease annually from a registered vet professional. Reporting for ATV in Bulawayo, Zimbabwe.
A Harare-based entertainer has been thrilling crowds in the city center with his ball and bottle juggling antics. Margaret Chirairo went to see the showman for ATV.
A Harare comedian, popularly known as Wasu, is entertaining audiences in the city center with his brand of jokes that touches on everyday problems and issues faced by the average Zimbabwean. The 45-year-old comedian is now earning a living through entertaining people with his ball and bottle juggling skills. ATV caught up with Wasu's fans in the Central Business District who were enjoying the comedian's antics.
I think
anoitawo kuti vanhu haya vanenge vasinazvo vanenge vachimanyira manyira kana kuti uine munhu anenge wakamirira hauzonyakurwadzika namudhorobha nokuti unogona kumboyiwa pani pawasu wombosungawo mbabvu uripo wakamirira chii zvaunenge wakamirira.
Wasu has entertained audiences across the country and some have even hired him to perform at their own private functions.
Isu tine mapurazi atinawo atakawana mushure mekunge tabva muhondo yerusununguko. Saka munhu atinotombotora chimboita tena vashandi vedu mapurazi atakawaniswa na president vedu. Saka munhu wekuti ukamutora anofadza vanhu vanhu vachiva nekunzwa kwakanaka kwete kuti vachisave nemabasa mamwe kuti vanopedzisira kubira vamwe asi kuti vachinzwa vachiita chinhu vachiva nemaentertainment zvino vava varaidzi chizomudzora hedu kunoko asi munhu ane nguva yakareba achiita basa rake.
Street theater has become popular in Harare and a number of popular comedians such as Freddy Manjalima, Kapfupi and Amon Vula rose to fame from performing in the streets. Reporting for ATV in Harare, Zimbabwe.
The Sports and Recreation Commission has organized a golf tournament to raise funds for the less privileged. Robert Tafumane went to find out more.
Proceeds from a Sports Recreation Commission organized golf tournament will benefit three charitable organizations in the country. Various organizations and individuals battled it out at the 18-hole Wingate golf course in Harare over the weekend. The Sports and Recreation Commission official said this is the second tournament they have organized to help the less privileged.
The objectives of the SRC Chairman's Golf Day are to raise funds for two main projects. The first one is to establish a sport development fund, which fund we will use for the purpose of assisting disadvantaged athletes, but who have a good future ahead of them. We believe that we also have a role to play in making sure that we raise the standards of those who are not as endowed as some of us.
Nemachena explained how the money was going to be distributed among the beneficiaries.
What we're going to do is the entire proceeds will be divided 50%, 50% between the sport development fund that I've talked about and the charities. Then among the three charities, they'll get an equal share of that 50%.
Each team paid the $200 fee to field a team over above the donations that they made to this worthy cause. This year's beneficiaries are Madzinde Primary School in Mashingo, Mother of Peace in Mtoko, and Cottage of the Orphans in Mashingo. Reporting for ATV in Harare, Zimbabwe.
Thank you for joining us. If you'd like to get in touch with ATV, you can comment on our Facebook site with your views. Have a pleasant evening.